Hello, welcome to Biology for You. In this video, we are going to discuss DNA polymerases in prokaryotes. In the series of videos, we have been discussing different concepts in molecular biology. So in this video, we are going to discuss how the discovery of DNA, different DNA polymerases were carried. So basically, in this video, we are going to have how the DNA polymerase 1, 2, 3 got identified. So went back to the history. In the year of 1953, Watson and Crick proposed the double helical model of the DNA. So according to double helical model of the DNA, there are two strands. One strand is complementary to the other strand. So each strand will act as a template and to copy down the sequences present in the template strand into the form of complementary new strand. So they also hypothesized that there must be a help of an enzyme which can copy like this. So based on that hypothesis, there was a race started to discover different polymerases in the prokaryotes. So basically, in that course of time, in the year of 1956, scientists named Otto Kornberg. So Otto Kornberg isolated first DNA polymerase from E. coli and named it as DNA polymerase 1. So basically, in his experiment, he used radio labeled DNTPs and the thymidine present in the DNTPs were labeled with P32, and the DNTPs were labeled with P32, and here they also added a template DNA and also a cell-free extract. So what would they expected? Maybe this cell-free extract, which may be rich with enzymes that could do manipulations in the DNA, so it may copy this template DNA by adding this DNTPs, and it may replicate the DNA, and the result was the same. After addition of the cell-free extract to the solution containing DNTPs and the template, it started replicating. That means addition of nucleotides was carried, and after that, when they isolated the DNA, the amount of DNA and its radioactivity was increased over the time. So it indicates that cell-free extract is having components that helps the DNA to be replicated. So the enzymes might be present in the cell-free extract, and there are some enzymes called the DNA polymerases, and due to the presence of DNA polymerases, DNA can replicate and copy down into the new strands. So during the discovery of DNA polymerase 1, basically after discovery of this DNA polymerase 1, the other enzymes are also discovered with similar activities. So those are DNA Pol2, DNA polymerase 3, and subsequently DNA polymerase 4 and 5 are also discovered, but these three are considered as the major replicating enzymes. So basically, we have three enzymes. They have discovered three enzymes, but the functions, which is the major replicating enzyme, and what are the axillary enzymes, and during their time, that was not known. So basically, how do the functions of there got relieved. So they used mutagenesis, that means chemical mutations. So basically, these chemical mutagens are the chemicals which can cause mutations in the DNA. So they used that kind of powerful chemical mutagens, and that were added to the culture of E. coli, so that the E. coli cells got mutated and they isolated colonies. So these isolated colonies were analyzed for the presence of different mutations, and thousands of such colonies were actually isolated and analyzed. So from them, they discovered one such colony with the mutation in its DNA polymerase 1. So after treating the culture with the chemical mutagens, they isolated many colonies and analyzed for the presence of DNA polymerase 1 mutation, and they discovered some few colonies with the mutation in the DNA polymerase 1. That means the DNA polymerase 1 enzyme is defective in that colony, and due to the defective DNA polymerase 1, actually despite of the mutated version of the DNA polymerase 1, the colony, the cells acted normally, they behave normally, they undergo further replication. But what did they observe? They observed that it is sensitive to DNA damage. So the cells with defective DNA polymerase 1 are actually sensitive towards the agents that causes damages in the DNA. That means they understood that this DNA polymerase 1 might have importance in the DNA repairs majorly. So they understood that the DNA polymerase 1 may not be a main replicating enzyme. So that is how the function of DNA polymerase was discovered. Coming to the next point, still we have two enzymes discovered later, DNA polymerase 2, DNA polymerase 3. But the functions of DNA polymerase 2 and 3 must be understood. So what did they do? Again, they isolated mutants. That means they again used this some mutagens, and the culture of E. coli is subjected to such kind of mutagens, and different colonies were isolated and analyzed for the presence of DNA polymerase 2 mutation now. So the cultures, that means the colonies with DNA pol 2 mutation were actually behaved normally. So despite of the mutation in the DNA polymerase 2 enzyme in them, they behaved normally. So there was not much changes in them got discovered. So they understood the function is not actually understood, and they concluded that this might be helpful in the DNA repair. So the third enzyme, the function of third enzyme, that is DNA polymerase 3, must be understood. So again, they introduced chemical mutagens to the culture of E. coli cells, and the mutants were isolated, and these kind of mutants were basically defective in their DNA pol 3 polymerase 3 enzyme, and these particular these particular colonies were unable to replicate. Basically, these type of mutant cells they discovered or they isolated are temperature sensitive. So these kind of temperature sensitive mutants were isolated, which are defective in the DNA polymerase 3 in such a way that at high temperatures they are unable to replicate, and at low temperature the DNA polymerase enzyme is active and they are able to replicate their DNA and behave normally. So at high temperature DNA replication is blocked, and at low temperatures it allows the DNA to be replicated. So these kind of temperature sensitive mutants got isolated, which are defective in DNA polymerase 3, and they understood that DNA because of the blockage of DNA polymerase 3 in the temperature sensitive mutants, basically what is happening, the DNA at lower temperature, it is along the when the enzyme DNA polymerase 3 is active, the replication is being carried, and when the DNA polymerase 3 is inactive, the cells are unable to copy down their sequences in the form of replication. So they understood that DNA polymerase 3 is the major replicating enzyme. This is how the functions of DNA polymerase 1, 2, 3 got revealed. So basically, come back to the first experiment, basically DNA polymerase 1 is also involved in the DNA replication procedure. But why these mutants of E. coli cells, which are defective in the DNA polymerase 1 in that specific experiment, were able to behave normally? So because the mutants that are isolated in that experiment were not completely or totally defective in the DNA polymerase 1, but they are having one active site which is responsible for the DNA replication. So scientists now understood that DNA polymerase 1 is also essential for the replication of DNA, but the experiment in this experiment the isolated DNA must not be the completely defective enzyme. So totally by now scientists understood that DNA polymerase 1 is also play active role in the DNA replication of prokaryotes, as well as the DNA polymerase 3 is a major replicating enzyme. So basically DNA polymerase 3, the function of it is to copy down the sequences, and it is responsible for the leading strand and lagging strand synthesis, and the DNA polymerase 1 is accessory to fill the gaps that were created during the replication process. And DNA polymerase 2 is the DNA repairing enzyme. So like this, the these kind of experiments were carried in which the DNA polymerase 1, 2, 3 got isolated, and the functions of the different DNA polymerases were revealed. So hope you understand this concept, and if you like, share and subscribe to my channel, and press bell icon for the further